Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, dear students. This is Pakistan International School Taif, grade 11. And we are going to start lecture number 27, Continuation with the Molecular Orbital Theory, MOT. So, in the previous lectures, we done some structures of the molecules according to molecular orbital theory. I told you for the hydrogen and their very important properties, and also I told you about the bond order. Now this is very important, and you done before that relative energies of the molecular orbitals. So 2 points I told you. Number 1 point was for the structure of oxygen, fluorine and their positive negative ions. If you are going to draw the structures of geometries of oxygen molecule, fluorine molecule and their positive and negative ions, then your sequence of filling orbitals according to the Bohr principle, Pauli's exclusion principle and Hund's rule is as under you done in the previous lecture as well. Sigma 1s, this is greater than sigma star 1s, then sigma 2s, sigma 2s, then sigma star 2s, then sigma 2px, which is very important, sigma 2px, then pi 2py is equal to pi 2pz. This is very important, we are going to discuss. And then pi star 2py is equal to pi star 2pz, then sigma star 2px. Like this. So this underline is very important if you are going to draw structures of the oxygen, fluorine and many other elements you discuss of the molecule, positive, negative ions. After the sigma star 2s, this is a common for all, must fill the sigma 2px. Means sigma 2px is less energy than that of pi 2py and pi 2pz in the case of these molecules and their positive and negative ions. Second, if you are going to draw the structures of hydrogen, helium, boron, carbon and nitrogen and their positive and negative ions, nitrogen is given in the book, then order is changed. Energy order is going to change after this. I am going to write sigma 1s, sigma star 1s, sigma 2s, sigma star 2s, then no sigma px, then you have to fill pi 2py is equal to pi 2pz. This is a change. And after filling this, then sigma 2px. And the same. Pi star 2PY, pi star 2PZ, and then sigma star 2PX. This is very important. We done in the previous lecture. So in this molecule, first sigma 2PX, and in these molecules and ions, first you have to fill pi 2PY, pi 2PZ, then sigma 2PX. So students, there is a reason, very important, and you have to give very attention towards here. Reason, see your book. Why this happened in the nitrogen boron carbon, why this is going to be deviate, why the rule is not obeyed? We have seen in energy order of lighter molecules, boron, carbon, nitrogen, sigma 2PX, sigma 2PX higher energy than that of pi 2PY and pi 2PZ given in your book. And this is the reversal due to the mixing of 2S and 2PX atomic orbitals. Why? Because of intermixing of2s and 2px atomic orbital. Okay, sir. Mixing of 2s and 2px atomic orbitals. Now in this case, we are talking about this one. Why does it happen that sigma 2px is higher energy than that of these difficult atomic orbitals? Molecules, this is a reason, please listen to me very carefully. Actually, the difference of the energy difference of 2s and 2p in these cases, the energy difference of 2s and 2p atomic orbital is very small. Energy difference of when you mix together, then between the 2s and 2p is very small. You have to underline and you have to note this one. Then there is a possibility of these mixing orbitals. You done the hybridization approach, same. Hybridization of atomic orbital, intermixing of atomic orbitals. As a result, sigma 2s and sigma star 2s molecular do not retain s character. No pure s character is when the sigma 2s and sigma star 2s molecular orbitals, they have a no pure s character. This is one thing. Similarly, in the sigma 2px and sigma star 2px, when there is a hybridization, also they do not have pure p character. Again, I am repeating. In the case of sigma 2s and sigma star 2s, they have a no pure s character. In the case of sigma 2px and sigma star 2px, they have no p character, but they have a mixed character s and p. There is a mixed character. These molecular orbitals have a s and p character. So due to the mixing of their energy change in such a way that molecular orbitals of sigma 2s and sigma star 2s become more stable are lower energy than that of molecular orbitals of sigma 2px and sigma star 2px. So see this one. These are the lower energy, and you see sigma star 2px highest one, and in this case sigma 2px is lower than pi 2py and pi 2pz. But in these cases, pi 2py, pi 2pz are less than that of sigma 2px. So that is why in the energy of molecular orbitals, as sigma 2px and sigma star 2px becomes less stable, and they are going to be raised. These are going to be raised higher energy than this. They are lower. If you draw, I will draw the diagrams of oxygen and hydrogen, you will then more understand. So these are going to be raised up, and they will be go down. These two, pi 2py and pi 2pz, they are down in lower energy, and sigma 2px raised. And this is the highest one up. So this is the reason. Since pi 2py is equal to pi 2pz is unchanged, the energy of pi 2py and pi 2pz is the same. Only sigma 2px is going to be shifted from lower energy to higher energy, raised. So such extent it becomes a higher energy than that of the pi bond. Read carefully this paragraph, very important. When you mix 2s and 2px atomic orbitals, so he said that there is very small difference in energy of 2s and 2p. That's why there is a mixing of hybridization. When sigma 2s and sigma star 2s mix, they have no pure s character. Mixing of the 2px and sigma star 2px, they have no p character, but they have a mixed character. Due to this reason, sigma 2px has a higher energy than that of 2py and 2pz. So this is the reason you have to give. And other one is that, why not for the oxygen and fluorine is going to be changed? Why they obey the all principles, Pauli-Jacques-Cuvier principle, Hund's rule, and also Aufbau principle? This is about why they are going to be obeying things written here. But in the case of oxygen, fluorine, do not do so. Not happening like this one. Same as the rules. For the oxygen, fluorine, do not do so. The reason is because high energy difference. In the previous case, in this case, there was a very small energy difference. And in this case, the difference of energy between this and this is a very high, that is given here. High energy difference of their 2s and 2p after mixing. And in the previous case, I told you there are very small differences there. So if you see that for oxygen, 1595 kilojoules per mole. Fluorine is a 2078 kilojoules per mole. This is the oxygen and the fluorine, very high value. But if you see for the boron, only 554. There's a lot of difference between energy of oxygen, fluorine and boron. So a lot of difference of their energies. 1595, 2078. Oxygen and fluorine respectively kilojoules per mole, and for the boron that is a 555 only, very very small indeed. For the boron 846 kilojoules per mole, and carbon is 1195 kilojoules per mole. This is calculation according to spectroscopic studies. All these terms are explained according to spectroscopic studies. So due to the lot of difference, very high energy difference between these and these, so this does not happen. Do not do so. And they
are going to obey the all principles and remain the same energies. So this is a very, very important. You must remember, you must understand that while you are going to draw the structure of oxygen and fluorine, then while you reach here after sigma star 2s, must sigma 2px, then pi 2py, pi 2pz. While you are filling for nitrogen, which is given in your book also, you are going to draw a structure according to nitrogen. So then, first you have to fill pi 2py, pi 2pz, then sigma 2px. And reason already I told you. The student, this is a very important thing, you must remember this. Now we are going to draw structures, applications. Applications of molecular orbital theory. Applications of molecular orbital theory. So we have diatomic molecules and there is a hydrogen, number one. Hydrogen, simplest element, atomic number is only one, and the electronic configuration is a 1s1. Electronic configuration is 1s1. So, energy increase from bottom to top. This is the potential energy. Increasing from bottom to top here. So you have 1s1 hydrogen atomic orbitals. According to definition, when the two atomic orbitals mix together, then the second one, and hydrogen atomic orbital. So when these two atomic orbitals mix together to form two molecular orbitals, as we done in the definitions, one is called bonding molecular orbital, which has a less energy, and another is called anti-bonding molecular orbital. So first form molecular orbital should be different spin. Like this one. And one electron of this one s of hydrogen, one electron of this hydrogen. So they make one s2 with a different spins. So this is called a formation of sigma bond. Between the hydrogen molecule, this hydrogen molecule is going to be formed. Yes, hydrogen molecule is going to be formed. And this is called a lower energy, it has a lower energy bonding molecular orbital. This is a bonding molecular orbital, and both electrons are going to be inter here, and no electron remain behind. So you must draw the antibonding high energy. Antibonding molecular is a high energy, and we call it sigma star 1s. No electrons there, because 1 and 1, 2 electrons must be present in the bonding molecular orbital. So this is sigma star 1s. It's called antibonding molecular orbital. So you should this structure of the hydrogen molecule. How the molecular orbital theory explains the structure of hydrogen. So this is the one thing. Then you have to write the electronic configuration. This electronic configuration, you have hydrogen, two atoms of hydrogen, each
one as one electron configuration by this one. So these are electron side, one hydrogen, second hydrogen, one as one key. Now it will form a hydrogen molecule as by electron configuration. So this hydrogen molecule is going to be formed, and how you write sigma 1s2, then sigma star 1s, no electron is here. This is the electronic configuration. Sigma 1s2, electrons are here. Sigma star 1s, no electrons. The only electronic configuration is sigma 1s2. Then there is a bond order I told you. The formula of bond order, I told you that number of electrons bonding molecular orbitals 2 minus number of electrons in antibonding 0 and divided by 1. So it will be 2 divided by 2, so 1. So hydrogen and hydrogen, there is a sigma bond only, single covalent bond is present. So dear students, these are the very important thing. Must write the electronic configuration, must draw this energy diagram. This is called energy diagram of hydrogen molecule according to the molecular orbital theory, and then you have to explain. 2 to 3 or 4 lines must explain this one. This is the structure of the hydrogen molecule. Same written in your book. So students, a very strong bond is here. 435. 435 kilojoules per mole amount of energy required to break. Minus if you give the formation of hydrogen molecule. Right? Formation is the exothermic and dissociation, bond dissociation is endothermic and formation is exothermic. So if you form plus sign, if you are going to be break this plus sign, and if you are going to form minus sign. So this is the 435 kilojoules per mole amount of energy is required to break this bond. And there is one thing more done in the chapter number 2 in the last topic, diamagnetic and paramagnetic. So there is a pair. If the electrons are paired, so the hydrogen molecule is a diamagnetic. So hydrogen is a diamagnetic, because there is a one electron pair in the molecular electronic configuration. So they repelled by both poles of the magnetic field. So this is about the hydrogen atom. And when the hydrogen molecule is going to be formed. Now students, I am going to explain about the helium. How helium molecule is going to be formed. This is a helium molecule. Atomic number of helium is 2. Atomic number of helium is going to be 2, and electronic configuration is 1s2, like this one. 1s2. Atomic number of helium is 2. Electronic configuration is a 1s2 about the helium. So it means that when the 2 helium atoms, they are going to form a helium molecule. This is the helium molecule is going to be formed. 2 atoms, 1s2, to form a helium molecule. So according to this energy diagram, so this is a helium atom 1. Electronic configuration is a 1s2. Paired. 1s2 is paired for the helium 1 atom, and 1s2 is also paired complete by the 2 electrons. This is like this one. So helium atom has a 1s2 electronic configuration because atomic number is 2. This is the one atomic orbital of helium and this is the second atomic orbital of helium. So according to the rules, first you form bonding, then you form antibonding. So S has only ability to occupy 2 electrons. So helium 1s2 is complete, 1 electron from here, 1 electron from here. Because 2 plus 2, so there are 4. So it shows also goes to antibonding. It must go to antibonding here. So 2 electrons in the bonding and 2 electrons in the antibonding. 4. 2 plus 2, 4. So that's why electronic configuration of helium is a sigma 1s2 and sigma star 1s2. Sigma helium, sigma 1s2 in bonded molecular orbital and sigma star 1s2 in the antibonding molecular orbital. This is the structure of the helium. How a helium molecule is going to be formed? This has an electronic configuration. I have written this. So if I am going to write its bond order, number of electrons in the bonding 2, number of electrons in the bonding also 2. So 0. Bond order is 0. It means that no bond is formed between helium and helium atoms. No bond. This question mark. No bond is going to be formed between helium and helium atom. It is a monoatomic molecule, you done in the previous classes. Monoatomic molecule. So this proof, molecular orbital theory proves that this is a hypothetical calculation for the formation of the helium molecule. When we calculate the bond order, the answer is 0. It means that there is no energy change and bond is not going to be formed in the helium molecule. 2 electrons are paired in the bonding molecular electrons and 2 electrons are paired in the antibonding molecular orbitals. So bond order is 0 and we concluded that molecule is not stable. Helium molecule is not stable. So helium molecule is not known, no bond is formed. So helium exists only as a monoatomic molecule. Monoatomic molecule is considered according to the inert gases because its K-shell. K-shell is a fully complete by 1s2. This is a structure of helium. It does not affect the magnetic field because complete. Now students, other structure is a lithium. Lithium molecule. So lithium has atomic number 3. Atomic number 3. So electronic configuration is a 1s2, 2s2 means 4. But we have to put one electron here. In the 2s1. So question is that how lithium
molecule is going to be formed 1s2 and 2s1. This is the formation of lithium molecule I will draw. Students, there is a easiness, simplicity for you. So if the higher atomic numbers are there, or the molecules are atoms, so in the drawing, 1s2 is complete as you done in the helium. So it means that this is the helium electronic configuration, 1s2 if I draw, 100% same drawing. But if you want to draw, okay, but if you don't draw, this is better, in the book it's not given. The orbital approach, orbital diagram for the 1s2 is not given. It's not necessary to draw. If you want to draw, okay, draw same for the helium, because there is 1s2. So only we draw the unpaired 2s1. Energy diagram, lithium atom, and there is a 2s1 atomic orbital. 1s2, again I am telling you, 1s2 K shell is completely filled. So if you want to draw, you draw as it is for the helium at molecule. But if you want to draw only for the unpaired 2s1, this is also sufficient. And here the same 2s1 for the atomic orbital. Lithium atomic orbital 2s1 and 2s1 is here. So these are the unpaired, so they are going to form a bonding here. Same. There are two. 2s2 sigma bond, and this is a bonding molecular orbital. Two electrons shifted to 2s2 and bond is going to be formed. Antibody, sigma star, 2s nothing, there is no electrons are here, anti bonding molecular orbital. So this is the energy diagram of the lithium. If you see your book, same is given here. So the electronic configuration is a 1s2 and 2s1. There are two more electrons in the bonding molecular orbital and no electrons in the antibonding molecular orbital. So this concluded that first I am going to complete electronic configuration. There is one technique. There is a technique for the writing. When I write electronic configuration, you have to mention also 1s. For the drawing, when drawing is concerned, they are good for drawing the 1s2. But when I write electronic configuration, this is a K shell, students. 1s2 is a K shell. You can write sigma 1s2 and the sigma star 1s2, it's okay. But if you write K and K, this K is for sigma 1s2 and this K is for sigma star 1s2, because there are two electrons in the bonding and two electrons in the antibonding. There are four electrons, so two to each, like this one. So this K and K is for the 1s2 each, sigma 2s2 and sigma star 2s2. So when it is a filled, write KK. Then energy is going to be increased. Then you have a sigma 2s2. Sigma 2s2 and sigma star 2s2 is empty. If you write, okay. If you don't write, also same. because there is a no electron.
There the low electron empty in the sigma star 2s. If you write, okay, if you don't know, you don't for this. Two electrons are here, the sigma 2s.
Bond order?
Number of electron in bonding? Only 2. Anti-bonding? 0. Divided by 2, answer is 1. So it means that the bond is existing in the lithium molecule. In the vapor phase, indeed in the vapor phase, it is going to be formed in the molecule and the weak bond is going to form 110 kilojoules per mole amount of energy is released when you are going to break the bond. And because of the two electrons are here in the pair, so it is diamagnetic. Lithium molecule is a diamagnetic which ripples through the magnetic field, and weak bond is going to form 110 kilojoules per mole amount of energy required to break this one. So this is the energy diagram, and this K and K is for the 1s2. This is the K-shell is complete, that's why I have written here. Sigma 2s2, this is a sigma s2s2 bonding, and sigma star 2s2 bonding MT1, and this is the bond order. And it's in the ripple phase, the molecule is going to be existing, and it should be a diamagnetic. So, dear students, this is a structure of the lithium molecule. In the beryllium, atomic number is 4. Atomic number is 4, 1s2 and 2s2. This is the electronic configuration of beryllium. 1s2 and 2s2. So when one beryllium atom reacts with other beryllium atom with the 1s2 and 2s2, K shell is again complete. So I will write here electronic configuration. So this is a beryllium. Be atomic number is a 4, and there are two electrons in the 2s2. 1s2 is not necessary to draw. If you want to draw, it's your choice. Already I told you this one. This is a beryllium, two atoms. Each two electron in the 2s2 and the 2s2 electrons, two are here. So, dear students, 4 electrons, 2 plus 2, 4. 2 plus 2, 4. So 2 will enter in the bonding molecular orbital. 2s sigma bond is going to be formed here. And 2 electrons will enter in the antibonding also. So 2 are bonding and 2 are antibonding. 2 plus 2, 4 there are. It means that there must be 2 electrons in the 2s lines. KK is same for the 1s, sigma 2s2, sigma 2s2, and then sigma star 2s2. So this is the geometry structure of the beryllium molecule. Bond order. In the bond order, there are 2 electrons in the bonding, 2 electrons in the bonding. So that's why 2 answers are 0. So zero, no bond is existing in the beryllium molecule. This is the diamagnetic, and beryllium molecule is unknown, but is a very, very unstable due to the zero bond order in presence in the beryllium. Electronic configuration, follow this. I always write electronic configuration as an attack. You have to do this one. Maybe in the book there is a maybe mistake, maybe there is some correction needs, so you have to write this one. I am writing very accurate. So this is a beryllium atomic number 4, and this is the 1s2, 2s2 electronic configuration. General beryllium, 2 atoms. 2 atoms of beryllium, they can react to give a beryllium molecule. This is going to be beryllium molecule, this is going to be formed here.
this beryllium molecule is going to be formed when the two beryllium atoms are here. This electron configuration of one beryllium atom, 1s2, 2s2, kj is a filled, kj is the filled for the beryllium, and two electrons shift in the 2s2 for the beryllium 1 atom, and this is the second atom of beryllium, atomic orbital to give a bonding molecular orbital, two electrons enter in the antibonding here, this is for the bonding, this is for the antibonding, two electrons, four electrons. So in the here bonding 2 and antibonding 2, so 0, you will have a 0, this is a highly unstable molecule here. So dear students, this is the structure of beryllium according to the molecular orbital theory. Next time inshallah, very important structures remain behind for the boron and also oxygen and nitrogen. These are the very important, you must remember this, and at home must revise these topics. These are the very, very important. We are going to stop here. In the next lecture we will discuss about the structure of boron, oxygen and nitrogen inshallah. Thank you very much.